Fire-labeled doors are doors with a fire-resistant rating that prevent the passage of fire and smoke between two compartments or areas of a building. These doors are used to protect people and property from fires. While conducting NSPIRE inspections, look for fire-labeled doors in the inside and unit inspectable areas. Check boiler rooms, mechanical rooms, common areas, stairwells, hallways, and entry doors. Before inspecting, ask the owner or property owner agent to disarm any exit alarms connected to fire-labeled doors. Identify all fire-labeled doors in the inside area along the participant's path of travel to the unit, including the unit's entry door and any emergency exits. Look for the fire label or plug on the edge of the slab between the middle and top hinge, or on the top and hinge side of the jamb or frame. If you cannot locate a label or plug, evaluate the door under the door general or door entry standards. Look for any objects that may prevent the door from closing and latching, including wood wedges, kick-down doorstops, trash cans, furniture, tape, plants, or rubber bands. Fire-labeled doors should not be held open by anything other than devices that release when the door is pushed or pulled, such as the door's own magnets. If a fire-labeled door is locked, ask the participant or owner to unlock it. With the door closed, engage the doorknob or handle to verify the door opens. Determine if the door is power-operated or has a self-closing mechanism, such as spring-loaded hinges, a pneumatic closer, or an automatic closure, like a magnetic lock. Activate power-operated doors and confirm they open automatically. For self-closing doors, open the door fully and release. Watch for it to close automatically. Verify the door closes completely and latches by pushing against it. If the door reopens or gaps are present, it is a fail. Missing or damaged components of self-closing mechanisms, automatic closures, or power operating systems are also a fail. Next, inspect each part of the door assembly, like the frame, door slab, hardware, or glazing. Any sized hole or damage that may compromise the integrity of the door are fails, such as cracked glass or unsecure or missing hardware resulting in a hole. Then, open the door again, and if there is evidence of prior installation, confirm that the seal or gasket is not missing. If present, ensure it is not torn or separating from the frame. Lastly, while inspecting fire-labeled doors in the unit, verify that at least one lock is installed and the door can be secured. For the inside, cite a deficiency only if the fire-labeled door is designed to have a lock, but the lock is missing or inoperable.
If you discover a unit entry door is missing and at least one other unit entry door along the same egress path has a fire label, then treat the missing door as a fire-labeled door and mark a deficiency. If a stairwell door is missing and at least one other stairwell door along the same egress path has a fire label, then treat the missing door as a fire-labeled door. For every NSPIRE standard, review the health and safety determination for each deficiency. As a best practice for the HCV program, photograph life-threatening or 24-hour deficiencies for the inspection report.
For more details about inspecting fire-labeled doors and other inspectable items, review the NSPIRE standards on HUD's website. To see more NSPIRE inspection videos and other training resources, visit HUD Exchange.